Hello everyone, my name is Parul Singh and I am reading a chapter from my book The Last Sunset. Time is ticking away, Mom. It has been a while since I have seen your face. I might be wrong. I have lost the count now. I don't remember when was the last time I saw you. I'm sorry for not telling you anything. I know you are angry. That's why you are not here next to me. I really am sorry. Please forgive me. I'm not able to sleep. These medicines and injections are not letting me sleep without any interruptions. I want to sleep. I'm feeling tired. What has happened to me? I don't remember, I guess. Or maybe I do. Everything is just so baffling and vague. I still am not able to hear any voice, but I am recognizing the faces. They keep speaking something, and I find it very hard to decode their words. The main thing is, you are not helping me here just like you did when I was a kid. I started speaking very late, unlike many kids of my age, and Mom never gave up on me. She was hopeful that someday I will. She kept trying and she was successful. Manan says that I have been speaking since then. He is just jealous. But this time, I am not able to speak. Not only speaking, I am failing to lift my body parts or blink my eye without feeling tired. I am just like any of these furniture and boxes they have kept in this room. They too are beneficial in some or other ways. I see Arjun counting the number of tablets I will be taking tonight. I really hate him. He knows I hate these yellow pulses, but he makes sure to feed me. I don't know what else I eat except pulses. I wonder what makes him laugh so hard. However, I don't mind because that's the only time I see him laughing or smiling. He doesn't smile like before. He's changing. And I'm not okay with this. I wish if I could tell him that I love his smiling face as much as I hate his watery red eyes. There is so much that I want him to know. Things that most probably are not related to him. But I just want to blurt everything out. I have been carrying all this for a bit too longer and I'm exhausted. I also know that I won't stop or pause in between. And he will listen, just like he always does. I want to tell him about my alcohol phobia, how it reminds me of all the broken houses and people I saw around while growing up. I want him to know that I need a human voice to wake me up every morning, no matter how much I hate humans. Why letters comfort me and how much I value silence at the same time. I want to tell him that his palms are filled with warmth, just like my mother's hand. And he shouldn't stop holding hands because not everyone is going to cut the cord. That he shouldn't stop making paper boats. I want to tell him why I don't like dancing in rains, but how much I love to watch it from the other side of the window. I want to share why I always wanted a garden filled with vegetables instead of flowers. And why I will always love to prod people to eat tomatoes. I want to share how bad I am at making airplanes. Why I prefer to sleep at night on the right side of the bed. He should know that I am okay with his habit of getting awkward while meeting new people. Hustling crowds doesn't comfort him. Birthdays and celebrations are not his thing. The fact that he is not someone who is everyone's favorite, and that's completely okay. However, I can't say anything. I don't know if I will ever be able to speak up. I don't want him to return back to this very place every day. I see him doing the same things, and I know that he is not at all comfortable here because hospitals scare the shit out of him. He barely leaves his seat and speaks something or the other the whole night. Sometimes, I do understand a couple of words and try to respond. I don't know why, but I don't feel like responding. He talks about sunsets, my family and food regularly. These are the words I decipher easily. His face looks different when I respond to his words. There's this strange glow and his eyes light up. I see him looking at my face or reading something on the machines, adjusting the oxygen mask or just walking up to the window. He has stopped talking about my mother. Earlier, they used to come together. I really wonder where she is. To be honest, I don't want her to see me like this. She will be worried. And no matter how much I try, I wouldn't be able to console her. Her birthday is coming. Or has it passed by? I remember how I and Manan used to bake a cake for her and how much we polluted the kitchen while working. Manan used to tease her for selecting butterscotch every year. He loved strawberry while I was okay with anything and everything. Mom used to give me the largest piece for I was the youngest member of the family. And I was the only working personnel amongst the two who never left the work midway. I would clean and decorate the whole house apart from gobbling the cake. Being the cleansing freak she was, Mom was biased towards me while giving her share of the sweet dish. And for the same reason, Manan had no option other than being okay with her decision. I don't even wish her this time. I am afraid that she will stop celebrating birthdays just like my brother if I wouldn't be by her side. I want her to know that I love her and that she is important. I also want to apologize to her for not being vocal about my feelings. But before anything else, I want to see her. Why is she not coming to sit next to me and tell me that everything will be all right? I'm sure something is not right. She can't be angry with me for so long. By the way, is that Arjun singing? He's such a bad singer. Thank God I can't hear anything. I think I'm feeling happy. I want to smile, but it's not happening. Hey Manan, I'm sorry. I know I have been troubling you since we celebrated my first birthday. From snatching your books to not letting you go out with your friends. I bothered you every single day. I remember how I used to stay silent for days at stretch and how you will nag me to speak something. Back then, we were not even teenagers, so you tried. But eventually, you stopped trying because maybe, just maybe, you thought that I didn't want to talk to you. Or you made peace with the fact that your sister was introvert to an extent that she disliked any human affair in the world. The reason why, you gifted me books on every Raksha Bandhan. I remember how I scolded you for your handwriting. It was bad. Worse, to be precise. But you worked so hard at it just because you knew how much I disliked bad calligraphy. You never complained when we stopped fighting all of a sudden. You never said a word when I told Mom that she loves you more than me because she always asks you whether you had your food or not. I never realized the fact that you were always careless regarding your meals. Given a chance, you would ditch your meal for studying or playing. I was always insensitive towards you. I always wanted attention. I always wanted people to talk about me and tell me that I am better than you in every aspect. I never appreciated the fact that Mom trusted you when she had to take any important decision regarding us or anything else. I disliked your habit of not complaining about anything. There were days when you slept without food. You never asked for gifts, lavished birthday celebrations, outings, and survived on limited resources unlike me. I always had this special plate. I was given the chance to select my favorite toy, pen, favorite pen, favorite lunchbox, bed, pillow, cupboard, everything. Over a period of time, I did turn a bit selfish and I wasn't sorry for being that way. I never liked what you liked. I always wanted your life. I wanted to be you. In spite of all this, you were always there for me when you had all the rights to not be there. You never misunderstood me or my silence. I was never vocal about my feelings, and you never asked me. Your actions always depicted that you were well aware about whatever I felt for you and Mom. You didn't say anything when you saw me spending days and hours in making gifts for Nishi. I barely gave you anything except a couple of letters. It was you who would bring me chocolates and toys, apart from books on every special occasion. I never even communicated you directly whether I liked it or not. Just like today, I'm not able to tell you that I hate to see you sitting like this with blank eyes. Replying you about something serious has always been so hard for me. You know, just like everybody, I used to think that I have a lot of time. And someday, I will confess everything. I will write all of this and many other things I want you to know and give it to you. But I was wrong. That's not how it works. Before I sleep, I want to tell you that I really like it when you feed those stray dogs and play with them. That you are so humane and this world needs more boys like you. I really love you for the way with which you behave with elder people. I always looked up to you and you never failed to teach me how to be the best version of myself from a very young age. Had you not been my brother, then also I would have respected you this much. Hopefully, I will be more vocal next time because that really helps. I wouldn't have felt this way had I told you all these things at the right time. It's just suffocating me right now. A lot. Thank you.